Hello everybody, welcome to my Plan Attack YouTube channel. Today we are going to take a terrible plan and we're going to make it much better. This is a 695 square foot, newly built one bedroom apartment in Costa Mesa, California. And as you can see from above, just by glancing at the floor plan, there's a whole lot of crazy stuff going on. It's not a very good design. We're going to have our work cut out for us to make it a lot better. So let's zoom in and start to look at some of the problems with the layout in more detail. Starting out with the front entry. When you walk in the front door, I never like a front entry that is only big enough to fit the door. It's too congested and too tight. The dining room is the shape of a stop sign, which makes absolutely no sense. However, I think the geometry of the building has dictated this shape and we're gonna have to work with it. It's also weird that the dining room window faces in towards the hallway or the outdoor entry space of the rest of the complex. The biggest problem with this whole plan has to do with the kitchen. I think this kitchen design is terrible. It is basically the shape of a giant hot tub. I don't know who wants to cook inside of a hot tub. The geometry of the eating bar mimics the geometry of the stop sign shaped dining room. The problem is if you put your stools here, you're basically gonna conflict with the circulation path into the rest of the unit. The door to the pantry swings out and it basically obstructs the entry into the kitchen. And there's not one, not two, not three, but four inside corners, which means there's gonna be very limited storage within this kitchen. Terrible design. If we look at some of the other spaces in the house, there's some problems too. Maybe not quite as terrible, but they do need fixing. I don't understand why we have an open closet in front of the master suite and this weird half wall, which I guess is where you put your martini before you go in to use the toilet. The bathroom is a segmented design with a separate toilet. Look at the vanity, no storage, it floats in the middle of the space, really, really, really awkward. The master closet also does not have enough width. Your clothes are gonna stick out into the swing of the door and I don't like when the doors swing into the master suite because it could obstruct with the bed or the night table. So we have all sorts of things to correct. I've done a little bit of work in advance and I want to show you what I've done in terms of an initial layout. I've demolished the wall at the front entry and I've created a coat closet, just a small closet, but I've set it back from the front door so there is enough room to come in, take off your coat, close the door without having a conflict. I've also created a drywall pantry within the kitchen. We'll work on the kitchen design in a minute. I've added a small linen closet storage near the master bedroom. It could also be a storage for board games or something for your living room. And I put a big storage closet opposite the master suite and the laundry. I've also fixed the walk-in closet with a pocket door so we don't have that swing issue. And I've created wide hanging on two sides. We don't have enough room for three-sided storage. So let's zoom in now and just talk about how we are going to detail the kitchen. I've got my magic ruler up in the Morfolio Trace. Let's look at this layout and figure out how we're gonna do this. So we now have an inside corner for the kitchen, which is very, very nice. We could have a couple of things. We could have an island. If we did an island, it would be kind of interesting because we could do it something like this, and then we could do a back counter like this, and you could get around both sides. I think that is a little bit problematic because there really isn't enough room to circulate around this. I think it might be better if we did a U-shaped kitchen as opposed to an island kitchen, just to make sure we have enough room for circulation. So the first thing I always like to talk about is where do you put the fridge? You could put the fridge here. The challenge with putting the fridge here is the door swing would probably open that way. That really restricts your ability to place anything else within the kitchen. I'm gonna suggest that we put the fridge next to the drywall pantry and basically create the door swing in a similar kind of way to the way that the pantry is. So how much space do we need for a fridge? Well, most fridges are between 30 and 36 inches and they are also around 24 to 30 inches deep. I think a shallow depth fridge generally tend to be more expensive. So I'm gonna do a counter depth fridge and I'm gonna draw it in at 30 inches deep and I'm gonna do it about 30 inches wide. So kind of a square. And we're gonna put the handle on the one side and I always like to test how we're gonna do the door swing. I think this is really important because when you're designing a kitchen, you want to make sure that that door does not conflict with any of your other counter spaces or any of your other appliances. So the fridge is gonna sit something like that. So now we can draw in the rest of the counters and I think it's interesting because we're gonna use this nubbin that I've created, which is basically another storage closet, to kind of end the eating bar counter. So if I draw the eating bar and I bring it all the way out, and let's kind of look at the alignment here, we could bring it out to the end of the drywall pantry, which actually is a pretty good size space. And how wide do we need to make that? Well, we need to make that around 3 feet. And why is 3 feet an important dimension? It's an important dimension because you need 24 inches for your cabinetry, and then you need to have 12 inches as an overhang for your seating area, which is really, really an important dimension that you need to remember as you're designing and laying out a kitchen. So I'm gonna make sure I've got my 24 inches on all sides, and I'm using my magic ruler to do that. And I can draw just in the back. I love drawing in the back lines of the kitchen counter. So now I have a kind of an outline of the kitchen. Now, interestingly enough, for those of you who think, oh, you should have done an island, remember, we have to leave 3 feet for that island in terms of getting access. That would mean our island would only be 6 feet long. And I think that is actually not enough space for a unit of this size. I think you could do probably a lot better with the peninsula. We're gonna get more storage. So I'm gonna put the cooktop in the end. I think that's actually a really good location to put the cooktop in the end position. And I'm just gonna draw it in for you guys using my magic ruler. I'm gonna say that it is gonna be 30 inches wide, which is 2'6". So that is 2'6", a little bit wider, that's good. And I'm gonna draw in the burners now. I love drawing in the burners. It feels satisfying to draw them in. I think it's actually really cool. And every time I draw a cooktop with the burners, I do it in a slightly different way. So if you look at all my designs that I've done in the past, no two cooktops are alike. They're kind of like fingerprints. It's very interesting, but you get the gist. That is what the cooktop in the oven is gonna look like. Now, in terms of the dishwasher, I always like to put the dishwasher on the end. And again, you need 2 feet, which is really, really important. And you have to make sure that you think about where the door swing is going to be in terms of the dishwasher, because the dishwasher door swings out and you don't want it to collide with any of the other portions of the kitchen. And then I'm gonna put the sink right next to the dishwasher, because usually the sink cabinet and the dishwasher need to go immediately adjacent to each other in order to connect the plumbing. So that is the layout of the kitchen. The one last thing that we should consider is, where do we put upper cabinets? And I think you obviously put them across the back above the cooktop, and then you put them again across the back section up to the fridge. So I think that is actually a really good layout for the kitchen. Now, going on to the bathroom, I think we just really need to simplify this. I think there's nothing wrong with having the bathtub kind of where it is, but I'm gonna opt for a shower. Remember, we have to leave basically the same width for the bathtub that we do for the shower. And I'm going to suggest that we do a shower with a bench at one end. I'm gonna use my ruler to draw the diagonal. The diagonal indicates that it is a shower with a drain in the center. Usually draw the lines to indicate where the drain is. So I'm gonna do the shower instead of the tub. And then I'm gonna put in the toilet. And it's really interesting, again, with the toilet, you need to leave 2'6" to 3 feet before you start the next vanity, before you start the next component, which in this case is the vanity, 2 feet in terms of depth for the vanity. Look at how much better this layout is already, because what I've got now is I've got room for storage and I've got a sink. And then I've got a toilet and I have left 3 feet. 3 feet is actually really, really good. I can just very quickly draw in the edge of the toilet, freehand style. So that is what I'm gonna do for the bathroom. I think this is starting to look really, really good. Let's just finish off with placing some of the furniture. This is kind of fun. Dining table. Well, I said we can't really do much about that stop sign based dining room. So I'm gonna suggest that we use a round table and we can place it with the chairs so that it actually makes sense in terms of the space. In terms of the living room furniture, a sectional sofa would be really great. I think that it could go in the corner, but we have to be aware of the doorway and the access. And I think that it would be really, really good if we had it so that it was located in the corner so that you can still get out to the deck and your TV would go against this wall. And then in terms of the master bedroom, the bed I think should rotate and it should be actually sort of closer to the front window so that when you come in, you can see the bed. It will allow for other furniture within the space. And then what's really interesting is when we add in the other components, the TV, a side chair, some a dresser and a TV in the master bedroom, we get the final look of the project. So I think this is much, much better. I'd love to hear what you guys think about all of these changes. Is there anything you would do anything differently? Is there anything that you think I've made this project worse with what I've done? I'd love to hear your comments. I'd love to hear what you guys think. So please send me a message, leave a comment. I'd appreciate all of your feedback.